guys. This is the Wicklow Gap, I think. And, well, that's what this bendy old sign up there that's all rusted to shit says anyway. So this is the Wicklow Gap. This is one thing I love about having a motorbike. You develop an understanding of the geography of the country. Do you know what I mean? Like, I've heard of the Wicklow Gap, but if you put, give me a map and don't let me point to it. Not a hope. But I can go home now today. Looking at a map, figure out where it is. Know where I've been, you know. Now there's a bit of a fucking change coming here now, I think. The weather could be running out of sunniness. Oh, now, go down the road the next time I woke up. Okay, Susie. Now, Lucky Luke, if you're listening now, and if you can get that drone of yours up here with the follow me function working. Now, there you go, Luke. There's the call out here. You want to go for a ride, bring your drone. Come up here someday. Wicklow Gap. And we'll run down here with the drone trying to follow you. So, into you. For anyone who doesn't know, and to be honest, if you don't know who Lucky Luke is and you're finding out about him from me, you're not really into the whole motorbiking, vlogging, motorvlogging scene. Luke is a Kerry chap, with what I consider to be very high quality content. You know, nice videos, nice scenery. I fear we're going to lose him to the drone world soon, though, because he's... We got about 80 videos on bikes in the last 2 years. And I think the last four videos he's put up, he's either talked about drones or featured drones. So I can see the appeal of the drone now, to be honest. I mean, I can see a few videos online of chaps that have them and have bikes. Like, they're an excellent thing for complementing something, like, you know, Fat Lad on a Bike has just got one recently, and he's done, you know, he did a tour in Ireland. He's a chap from Yorkshire area, not really sure where now, to be honest. Scunthorpe kind of region, I think. And I am open to correction in case he's ever watching this. But he's got one as well, and I mean, I can only see it adding to his footage, because he does some quality videos of scenery that he encounters on his trips. Like, he did a 4 day or 5 day trip around Ireland. He did a trip around Switzerland as well, and I mean, the footage that he gets is just incredible. Like, and I think he would make really good use of a drone to kind of augment augment his footage. Now, Mr. Biker Buddy, if you want to go on ahead, now you go ahead. Ballsy enough to do that now in my first run on this. A long way down in there if you got it wrong. Just wouldn't do it. I'm glad he didn't get away with it, like, but I wouldn't be able to. And already I have a feeling I'm following that fork too closely, because if there was something under his wheels, I wouldn't see it in time. But you can like this with zipping past. Maybe these are lads who are out every Sunday on this knot, like the back of their hands. Well, up, Matt? Where are you? there, so that's a good sign. Likelihood of a bridge coming up soon is greatly increased by the presence of the river.
After 200 meters, you will reach your destination.
Woohoo! And drop down.